Okay, so yesterday we started the order of operations, which we went over was parentheses, exponents, multiplication and division left to right, addition and subtraction left to right. And the way to remember that is by saying the statement, "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally." So, you know, can you start reading where it says when, I think?
When simplifying expressions, it is important that we simplify them in the correct order. Consider the following problem done. Well, I think I'll say that.
Read it.
Consider the following problem done two different ways. Where you want the problem?
Mm-hmm.
2 + 5. And then it has a 3. I don't. You know those boxes in the back. You can.
Look at the rewritten. It's times 3. Alright, so read that paragraph, sentence again.
When simplifying expressions, it is important that we simplify them in the correct order.
So, according to our order of operations, the rules, what should we do here first?
Parentheses. Should multiply.
Okay, we should multiply. So we're going to be multiplying 5 times 3. So it's going to be 2 plus 15. And then 2 plus 15 is 17. So if we didn't know our order of operations and we had just solved it left to right, doing addition first, we would have done 5 plus 2, which is 10 times 3, and then 10 times 3 would be 30. So as you can see, that gave us a completely different answer, which is why it's important that you know and understand the order of operations. Want to keep reading?
The previous example, it illustrates that if the... Multiply and divide are on the same level because they are the same operation. Division is just multiplying by the reciprocal. This means they must be done left to right. So some problems we will divide first, others we will multiply first. The same is true for adding and subtracting. Subtracting is just adding the opposite. Often students use the word PEMDAS to remember the order of operations, as the first letter of each operation creates the word PEMDAS. However, it is the author's suggestion to think about PEMDAS as a vertical word written as P-E-M-D-A-S. Do you want me to keep going?
You read this one now.
I read that one. So we don't forget that multiplication and division are done left to right. Same with addition and subtraction. Another way students remember the order of operations is to think of a phrase such as, "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally," where each word starts with the same letters as the order of operations start with. Read the next problem.
That's what's next? There's no paragraph?
Mm-mm.
No sentence?
Yeah, there's a... Nope.
Okay, so we did an example yesterday showing how to work from the inner parentheses to the outer. The same goes with, sure, some of you probably have heard of absolute value, which is marked like that. That's also sort of like a parenthesis, so if you were to see that and there's a problem within it, then you will work that first as well. Does anybody know the definition of absolute value? This is just a little tidbit. So absolute value is the distance from zero. That's why anytime there's a number in absolute value, so if I had the absolute value of 4, that would be 4. Absolute value of -4, were equal to 4. And that's because it's the distance from 0. So either way I go, if I go to positive 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, I move 4 places. If I go to negative 4, I move 1, 2, 3, 4 places. So that's why it's always positive.
Okay.
Because it's the distance you're moving, not necessarily what you're going to.
So we're going to work another one like we did yesterday just to show. So 1, 6, 3 times the absolute value of negative 4 squared minus negative 8. Plus 2 times the absolute value of 3 plus negative 5 squared. All right, so where can we start?
In the first one. Exponent.
What's that plus 2? What is that adding?
I say 1 plus 3 times the absolute value of this plus 2 times the absolute value of this.
So the negative 8, like the multiplication. So
I was saying 1 plus 3 exponent times negative 4.
Negative 4.
So,
negative 4.
So what did you do where negative 4? What's the second power?
Okay, so we're starting within this parentheses, or the absolute value. That's what I was looking at. Okay, so we're starting here, because all of this is within a type of parentheses, which is, this one is called absolute value. So this is going to be, and within that, what do we do first?
Do the exponents.
So we do the exponents first. All right, so negative 4 squared
is going to be negative 16.
16. Notice negative 4 squared is positive 16, because when you square a number, you're just multiplying it by itself, and a negative times a negative is a positive. So negative 16 minus negative 8, we can rewrite that as 16 plus 8, which is equal to
8.
16 plus 8?
Oh, no.
24.
Alright, so then we can rewrite our problem. Three times the absolute value of 24 plus 2 times the absolute value of 3 plus negative 5 squared.
So don't you do the negative 5 squared? The second.
So we're gonna work in this absolute value now. A form of parentheses, and it's gonna be negative 5 squared.
Negative 25.
Negative 5 squared.
Oh, yeah.
25. And 3 plus 25 is 28. So then we have 1 plus 3 times the absolute value of 24. We said anything that's the absolute value is going to be positive, so that's going to be 24 times 24. Plus 2 times the absolute value of 28. Alright, so what's our next step first?
Multiply 23 times 24.
Why 3 and 24?
Because you go work from left to right.
Alright, so 1 plus 3 times 24 is?
72. 8 and 62.
72 is right. Plus 2 times 28
equals 46 or
56.
Alright, so now we can just add across. So 1 plus 72 is 73 plus 56 is
there are several parentheses in a problem, we will start with the innermost parenthesis. There are several types of grouping symbols that can be used besides parentheses. One type is a fraction bar. If we have a fraction, the entire numerator and the entire denominator must be evaluated before we reduce the fraction. In these cases, we can simplify in both the numerator and denominator at the same time.
Alright, so what that's talking about is, you might have something like this. 2 to the 4th power. Minus negative 8 times 3. Alright, and then under that you have 15 divided by 5 minus 1. Alright, so, well, it doesn't matter which one you do first. Alright, so, starting in the denominator, according to the rules, what would we do first?
15 divided by 5.
Alright, so division, 15 divided by 5, is going to be 3. And then we have 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. So that's our denominator. We go to the top, we have 2 to the 4th power minus negative 8. Times 3. So, what are we going to do first?
The 2 to the power 4.
Alright, so 2 to the 4th power is?
16.
For anybody that doesn't know exponents, anytime you have something to the power, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, that's just how many times you're multiplying this number by itself. So, 2 to the 4th power will be 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. And 8 times 2 is 16. So don't mistake that for multiplication and do 2 times 4, because that would be 8. It's times itself that many times. So like I said, 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. And something to keep in mind, if this 2 is negative, and I had 2 to the 4th power, it would be times negative 2 each time. So it would be 2, negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. 4 times negative 2 would be negative 8. Negative 8 times negative 2 would be positive 16. If it was negative 2 to the 3rd power, it would be negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2, which will be negative 2 times negative 2 equals 4. Positive 4 times negative 2 would be negative 8. So if it's a negative number, and you have a odd number for an exponent for the power, then the answer is going to be negative. If it's a negative number and it's to a positive exponent, then it's going to end in a positive. So we did 2 to the 4th power, which is 16, so then minus negative 8 times 3. And so what do we do next?
Negative 8 times 3.
So next we do our multiplication, negative 8 times 3. Gonna bring us to 16 minus
24, negative 24.
Negative 24. We can rewrite that as 16 plus 24, because we're subtracting a negative, same as addition. Which is 40. Yeah. So our numerator will be 40. And now we can simplify this. So 2 goes into 40 20 times. Ready? What does it say next? complement?
It has one.
What does it say?
I said it has one.
What does it say? Like,
oh. Oh, you mean what the problem says?
What does it say before that?
That one? It just says example 28. I read that.
Okay, that's what we just did. So go down here.
Another type of grouping symbol that also has an operation with it, absolute value. When we have absolute value, we will evaluate everything inside the absolute value, just as if it were a normal parentheses. Then once the inside is completed, we will take the absolute value or distance from zero to make the number positive.
Okay, so we already kind of went over that, but we'll just do a short one again. So I have 1 plus 2 minus the absolute value of 5 minus 6. So, what would I do first?
You do 5 minus 6.
So, you do the absolute value first. 1 plus 2 minus the absolute value of, it was 5 minus 6.
Negative 1.
Absolute value of negative 1 is 1. So, minus 1. So now we can do our adding and subtraction from left to right. 1 plus 2 is 3, minus 1 is 2.
The above.